production is brought to you by Chatham Conservation Partnership. Chatham County is located in central North Carolina on the eastern edge of the Piedmont. It has a population of over 63,000 people. Gently rolling hills and rivers comprise the landscape of Chatham County. It lies entirely within the Cape Fear River Basin and is drained by three major rivers and tributaries, the Haw, the Deep, and the Rocky Rivers. The streams and rivers in the county feed into the Cape Fear River, the largest river in the entire state. Chatham County thus possesses a wealth of riverine habitats. The Haw and the Rocky Rivers flow in a southeasterly direction across the county. The Deep forms part of the southern border of Chatham, where it flows northeasterly before turning to the southeast in neighboring Wake County. These waterways and tributaries have greatly dissected the uplands in some places and have meandering broad floodplains in other places. These rivers are also home to the federally endangered and endemic Cape Fear Shiner. The Cape Fear Shiner is a small minnow approximately 2 inches in length, distinguished by its black banded sides, pointed yellow fins, and long black upper lip. The Cape Fear Shiner's unique elongated intestine allows it to consume a mostly plant-based diet. The Cape Fear Shiner is sexually mature after the first year and can live up to 6 years. Natural predators of the Cape Fear Shiner are the flathead catfish, bass, and crappie. It was not discovered until the 1960s and was later listed as endangered with critical habitat on September 25, 1987.
Brina and I work for the Wildlife Diversity Program, where we strive to keep species off the endangered species by working to maintain viable populations, with emphasis on priority species that we've put into our North Carolina Wildlife Action Plan document. When I started with the commission in 2003, one of the first locations that I sampled was in the Rocky River, where there are Cape Fear Shiners, and I started learning more about that species at that time. And a part of my work duties with the Wildlife Commission is to monitor populations of rare species, including Cape Fear Shiner. Some of the threats for Cape Fear Shiner include altering of their stream habitats or destruction of their habitats. Cape Fear Shiner is a species that lives in shallow waters, and one of the things that can greatly impact their population is the construction of a dam. And when you build a dam and the lake that's formed by that structure, it doesn't provide the habitat that this species needs, so they get extirpated from that area, and so that fragments their habitats below the dam and upstream of that impoundment. And another thing that impacts populations of aquatic species is water quality. They need good clean water.
Yeah, and one of the things that has caused the largest change to aquatic environments both in North Carolina and across the U.S. is the introduction of sediment into streams and rivers. And this comes from several different sources, but one of the largest sources is when land is cleared for development. And often what happens is land is cleared all the way up to the edge of the stream or river. And the riparian zone along the edge of the stream, which is usually forested in our area, is removed. And that sediment can run unchecked into the river. And what that does is it not only causes the water to be turbid or cloudy, which prevents fish from seeing their prey, it also covers the bottom of the river. And species like the Cape Fear Shiner often need a very clean substrate along the bottom, clean gravel, cobble, exposed rocks where they can nest and lay their eggs. And if that's covered up by sediment, then they're not going to be able to successfully breed there. You know, two of the biggest pressures for any wildlife species right now comes with population growth and climate change. You know, climate change means there's going to be more frequent drought conditions, precipitation patterns are going to change, so the availability of water is going to change in the future. You couple this with population growth, there's going to be an increased demand for less water. So this is obviously going to be a big variable to take into consideration when managing aquatic species.
So with those things in mind, you know, if we can thoughtfully and responsibly plan for the future, you know, the growth and protecting water quality and quantity can coexist. So those are things that we try to talk to people about, that those are not mutually exclusive ideas. You know, we can work together and work towards a planning that's smart.
They like to live, usually, in medium-sized rivers like the Deep River, the Haw River, Rocky River, even the Cape Fear River. Although they are sometimes found at the lower ends of the tributaries that come into the river, they'll move up in those areas in the spring to spawn and inhabit those while the water is available. They like habitat that has a lot of variability in it, areas where there are run riffle complexes that are very rocky. They like to hang out in little eddies behind rocks and then move out into the riffle area to feed or to school with other species of fish in that area. They also like vegetation that grows in the river, and they use that for shelter, for predators, that kind of thing.
In many of the habitats that you find Cape Fear Shiner in, you also find, you know, water willow. But we're not exactly sure what that association is, but you do find, you know, that as a characteristic of their habitat. Yeah, I mean, one of the things that I've noticed that was interesting is that they don't always occupy what we think is their typical habitat. You know, sometimes you can find Cape Fear Shiners in deeper areas that aren't near a riffle or a shoal, and they're associated with the kind of a slower moving water near woody debris. And perhaps, you know, they can utilize a little bit broader kinds of habitats than what we previously thought.
Another thing that is neat to the Cape Fear Shiner is within the group of shiners that live in these river systems, they're the only one that we're aware of that is primarily a grazer. They feed on algae and other vegetation in the water, and they have a longer intestine than other species in their genus, probably to digest that plant material, because, you know, plant material is harder to digest than a bug or something like that. This also may help make them more resistant to drought conditions, since they have a different food source that they can utilize. They're not dependent on the bugs that the other minnow species are.
One of the things that I think is also very interesting about Cape Fear Shiner is that they have one of the smallest distributions of fish in this family. They're only found in just a few counties, and it's only found in this portion of North Carolina. So this is a unique species. This is an endemic species for us. It's found here and nowhere else in the world.
Over the last three decades, the Cape Fear Shiner has undergone a change in population range and sizes. Five populations are known to exist within three listed critical habitats. Kind of messed up undergone. According to local ecological experts such as Gerald Potter, Chatham County has been proactive in protecting and rehabilitating the Cape Fear Shiner. It has established stream buffers and high levels of environmental review for new projects. Aggressive stormwater management policies have been vital to protecting fish populations. It is imperative that Lee and Randolph counties join Chatham County in the effort to protect the Cape Fear Shiner. The state needs to assist local efforts by establishing riparian buffer requirements along the Cape Fear, Haw, Rocky, and Deep Rivers. Why should we care about the Cape Fear Shiner? This is a question often applied to endangered endemic species. While the world will not end if the Cape Fear Shiner ceases to exist, this species is an important indicator of air, land, and water quality. Protecting this small fish species requires protecting habitat that also supports the human species.